has a bearing on what happens on the roads. Plus, if I understand the way the effluence is going to be distributed, at the least expensive way for Toll Brothers to construct, it's going to affect all the properties that run towards the dump. Here they go. And, you know, I don't think anybody wants to be drinking the water.
Thank you, ma'am. Mr. Adelman.
Ma'am, you testified just a moment ago that you believe your property is located beyond the half-mile radius. Do you see your property on the exhibit A0?
I don't know. Do you see the crossroads of 926 and where the school is?
Which school, ma'am? Ruston?
Yeah.
It's not located on the plan, is that correct, ma'am?
It's right, it's not, but I would like to state that even though a good number of us are not on the half-mile route, we're all affected by what's happening with a huge bunch of houses going up at that property.
Understood, ma'am. I'd object on the basis that her property interest is located beyond the half-mile radius and that the stated concerns are nothing more than the generalized concerns of township residents.
Look at my house falling down. It's just a generalized concern.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Your request will be considered by the board, noting the objection of Mr. Adelman, and a decision will be rendered at next month's meeting. Yes, ma'am.
Hello, I'm Jennifer Kramer, 1046 Dunvegan Road. I submitted my application with neighbors for pre-billing, but I would also like individual apartment status.
I apologize. Could you tell me your address again? What?
1046 Dunvegan Road.
Ma'am, do you own the property?
I do not. I'm a resident. My father owns it.
What is your father's name?
Jeffrey Kramer. That's G-E-O-F-F-R-E-Y K-R-A-M-E-R.
Mr. Adelman?
I'm sorry, Mr. McKenna, did I hear? Are you a permanent resident at that location?
Yes, I am.
Okay, I have no objection based on her residency at that location.
Thank you, Ms. Kramer. You'll be admitted as a party.
Thank
you. Do you have a party status form? Have you filled one out?
I gave it to the neighbors pre-billing.
All right, all right, so that's included in the packet that we already have. Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am.
Megan Bruns, B-R-U-N-S, at 4 Jacqueline Drive. I submitted my paperwork for neighbors for Creebly as well, but would like to request individual party status.
Good evening, Ms. Bruns. Do you own the property?
Yes.
And could you please state how you're affected by the application?
Sure. Being on Jacqueline Drive, like mentioned before by other residents, it's a major cutthroat. It affects the safety of the residents in Westtown, as well as the traffic. It's already been under study by the township and has not yet been rectified. It's a concern with over 700 vehicles traveling per day. So with this new development and the influx of cars and traffic adding to Jacqueline, it's just going to be a nightmare, as well as the influx in an already crowded elementary school, Starkweather, which was currently redistricted and at this point, as far as I know, has no available empty classrooms for an increase in population.
Thank you. Mr. Adelman.
Good evening, ma'am. Could you please indicate on exhibit A0 the area where your property is located? Please let the record reflect that she's indicated beyond the half-mile mark. On that basis, I'd object again, on the basis that her property interest is beyond half a mile from the perimeter of the property, as well as the stated concerns being of a generalized nature.
I would also like to state that the property at Jacqueline Drive is right on the cusp of that yellow line and that half-mile mark, and is a huge area of concern.
Thank you, ma'am. Your request will be taken under advisement by the board, noting the objection of the applicant, and we'll give a decision at the meeting in March.
Thank you.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I have no other party status forms in front of me. One final call for party status. All right, not hearing any and noting that it's about 7:45, why don't we go ahead and take our break now? Mr. Edelman, you're telling me no.
I just have one point of question as to any party trying to get future party status at subsequent hearings. I would object to, on the basis that it would be prejudicial to introduce new parties subsequent hearings.
We'll note the objection. If it comes up, we can raise it again at that time.
Thank you.
All right, so we're going to take about a 15-minute break, and we'll start back up again at 8 o'clock. Mr. Edelman will begin presenting his evidence for his case in chief. Thank you.